Well, good morning, everyone. This technology that we're talking about today provides just staggering possibilities for conservation and research. And as an ornithologist, I couldn't be more excited about the possibilities that we could actually, at some point, bring birds back from extinction. But ornithologists are not the only group of people that are excited about birds and bird conservation. There was a recent survey that showed 48 million Americans consider themselves birders or bird watchers. That's 21% of our population. Americans spend $37 billion a year on bird watching. There are almost 500,000 members of the National Audubon Society. And in 1 month, the Cornell Lab of Ornithology had over 3 million observations reported to their eBird network. It's staggering. It's a lot of people involved in bird watching and ornithology. And you can only conclude people want birds, people love birds. There are many people that would be very interested in having birds come back from extinction, or at least having very endangered birds have a better chance at survival. So before we talk about bringing them back, we need to talk about what we've lost. So this figure shows the distribution of extinct species by the order of bird in which they occur. And I want to focus on four of those groups. The biggest group is the biggest group of birds, the passerines, the perching birds, and we've lost about 70 species of perching birds. One of the most interesting are the huia from New Zealand. They are wattle birds, and they were basically loved to death by the Maori people. They were used in their ceremonies and religious activities and so forth, and so, of course, they used a lot of them. One of the things that's interesting about huia from an ornithological perspective is look at the bills. Look at the difference in the bill shape between the male and the female. And people have hypothesized that it provides the pair of birds an interesting way of being able to forage together, but on different foraging foods. Another group we're concerned about are the rails. We've lost about 34 species of rails. They are principally the flightless rails that have disappeared from South Pacific islands. An interesting member of this group are the takahe. The takahe are the largest rails we know of, and they went extinct early on as a result of some climate change, and then later on, with the coming of Europeans to New Zealand, they were hunted and they brought predators and so forth. So, in any event, pigeons and doves are a group we're going to hear about a lot today. We've lost about 18 species of pigeons and doves. The primary one we'll hear about today is the passenger pigeon. And we've lost about 19 species of parrots. And one of the species of parrot that I think most people in North America will be most familiar with is the Carolina parakeet. Carolina parakeets were very widespread across the eastern United States all the way up to Wisconsin, and they occurred in large flocks, and after a while, farmers viewed them as a group of birds that were depredating their crops. So there was a lot of hunting that was done, and unfortunately, with Carolina parakeets, if you shoot some of the birds and they fall to the ground, the others will come down to be with them, which of course meant they got shot as well. So, if we're going to understand extinctions for birds, what we need to do is put it in perspective in terms of birds that have gone extinct in continents versus those that have gone extinct on islands. 87% of the birds that have gone extinct were island species. And when you look at this figure, it shows you not only how species have gone extinct, but compares between islands and mainland species. So if we look at the reason species go extinct, it has to do with overexploitation, hunting basically, habitat loss or alteration, invasive species, cats, rats, snakes, whatever, and disease, like we found in the Hawaiian birds. And when you compare the continental population or continental species that have gone extinct, they have gone extinct principally because of habitat alteration or destruction, whereas the island species have principally gone extinct because of introduction of invasive species. Now, I want to take a minute and focus more on this idea of island species and talk about some of our work in the Pacific Islands, and specifically the island of Ponape, which is indicated by the triangle. Ponape is in the Federated States of Micronesia, just north of New Guinea. And the thing that's interesting, one of the things that's interesting about Ponape is the fact that they have an intact avifauna, which means that they have one of most species or types of birds that are found or used to be found on Pacific Islands. So they have one kingfisher, one white eye, one parrot, one fruit dove, one flightless rail, one fantail, and so forth. Many islands have lost those components. And one of those islands is the island of Guam, which has lost pretty much everything because of introduction of the brown tree snake. But we've worked on Micronesian kingfishers for years, and I can tell you, as I listen through the talks and understand more about the technology that's being developed, it could absolutely provide some hope that we could take what's left of the Micronesian kingfishers in captivity and successfully have them live on another island and prosper. So this has all been kind of doom and gloom, right? Environmental talks sometimes tend to go that way, but what if you just stopped for a moment and you said, okay, forget all the terrible things, just what if there were a possibility that we could bring birds back from extinction? What would that mean? And I think, in my mind, it would mean something like, here we can enjoy George Sutton's beautiful ivory-billed woodpecker, but why not just see it? Why not see it in the wild? Or we can see this cartoon of the great auk, but why not be able to watch it in its natural habitat? The great auk was found throughout the North Atlantic and it was hunted to death, but it would be an incredible thing to see. It's basically the penguin of the Northern Hemisphere. Okay, so let's say we could, there are possibilities. How would we choose birds to bring back? Now, today we'll talk about, other people will talk about philosophical and legal and many things, but I wanted to focus on just the ornithological perspective. What is it we would take, what would it take to bring back something like these Labrador ducks? So we would want to think about criteria such as you're looking at right now. It would help if it was a bird that had recently gone extinct, because it would probably mean that we had a number of individuals in museums to sample from. There would be better genetic tissue. We might want it to be a non-migratory species, because if you only have one or two and they fly away, you're going to cry. Birds have amazingly complex mating systems, but in this case, we might want to choose a simple monogamous mating system. Why not choose a bird that lays a lot of eggs? Grow the population faster. This is sort of silly, but it's true. If we are using surrogates, you want the female surrogate to be able to lay an egg the size that she's able to deal with. We do not want chickens laying moa eggs. And the final thing is, we'd want to think about parental care. We would want to be sure, in a perfect world, that the chicks would be able to hatch and walk around and feed themselves immediately, rather than having to be to hatch without feathers and so forth. So, who would benefit? When the Cornell lab found the ivory-billed woodpecker, people were ecstatic. Articles in the New York Times, Arkansas changed their license plate. It was incredible. But scientists would benefit as well. And conservation efforts could benefit. Hunters and sportsmen could see some of their species come back. And wouldn't it be cool for people in Hawaii to have at least one of their honeycreepers back? So these possibilities that I'm proposing are complex. They make my head spin. And, you know, when things make my head spin, the best thing I can think of to do is to go bird watching. Thank you. Thank you.